To access your grades in our class, you can click on the grades page, and it's important that you keep an eye on the totals here. So assignments in our class are worth 50% of the final grade, your journal work is worth 10%, and the chat book is 40%. So pretty much for most of our class, all of the grades will be related to assignments. Not until the end of the course will you have some grades related to the journal and the chat book. Right now, you'll notice a few different things here. So let's talk first about the total grade. Over in the upper right corner is where you will find the total grade for your work in the class. It's also only calculating right now based on graded assignments. If I uncheck this box, it's going to tell me what my grade would be as if I did not submit this last assignment. But we're going to usually, I would suggest you keep that box checked. You'll also notice here some items are grayed out, and actually a lot of them are grayed out here. The syllabus in our class indicated that some of the work in our assignments category is going to be dropped. So you'll notice that your three lowest assignment grades are dropped from the overall grade. And I've set that up already within the Canvas system. So right now, Lamont quote and response, our story, and the orientation quiz are being dropped from this test student's grade. And you can tell that because it's grayed out. It's going to automatically keep populating those dropping of the three based on what those three lowest grades are. In this instance, the score was 10 out of 15. So if I went here and let's say I said I, for whatever reason, got 20 out of 15, you'll see that then intro survey is not considered in the total calculation. And get used to this hovering. When you hover over, it's going to tell you more information about the item. So in this instance, this is being dropped, this is being dropped, and this is being dropped. This work right now is not considered yet because it hasn't been submitted. Now, one of the things you do have the power to do is actually test out different scores. So if you wanted, you could predict what your grade might be if, for instance, let's say there was some opportunity to get extra credit on this assignment and I had gotten 20 out of 10, that would change my overall grade to 118. You'll notice here that it tells you this is not your official score. So what if grades essentially indicate, it's more likely you will use it as we get further in the semester. You might use it to predict, say, what you might get on the journal assignment and how that would affect your overall grade. You can always revert back to your actual score, and you can put as many what-if grades in as you want. It's not going to change it in the actual system. They are simply what-if grades. So in my gradebook, it's going to reflect 100% for this student until new grades that I have entered are in the system. The other thing you can notice here are these icons. So this is a comment icon. This is the scoring detail. And if you see a rubric, it's going to show you the rubric. You can interact with any of these items, and it's going to show you the scoring detail. It's going to show me the rubric. So if you want from your grades page, you can do quite a bit to find information out about these assignments. The other thing I'd encourage you to do from a grades page, let's say on our story, I got a 0, and so if I look at the comment that left by the instructor, and I was curious about that, I could actually click right on that assignment, and it's going to take me directly into that part of the course where that assignment lives. So I could check out the actual assignment again and see, oh, is my post here? Maybe it's missing. I could hit back, and then if I wanted to post a comment related to that assignment, I could certainly do that. So you can actually add that comment, tie it to that assignment, and then we can converse related to that particular grade in the course. So again, from your grades page, anything that has got gray and not blue indicates that the assignment is being dropped. You also see the X indicating that. Right, the grade is always defaulted to calculate only based on those items that have been graded. Icons on the right, comments, the scoring detail, and rubrics. Those are interactable, so you can see what the assignment specifications are for that given assignment. And then the percentages and weights based on category grouping.